हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम इन बायोलॉजी क्लास क्लास 11। वे आर स्टडिंग चैप्टर नंबर 4, दैट इज एलिमेंट एनिमल किंगडम, इन विच वी ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द बेसिक ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब एनिमल क्लासिफिकेशन विच इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन एज वेल एज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर योर लाइफ। सो हियर इज टेबल that is so the linear representation of different classes of animal which are on the basis of their symmetry, body of organization and body cavity as well as their classes. So let us one by one in the general introduction about the animal kingdom by the table. So first, this is so the kingdom. We are studying about the animals. So kingdom is Animalia. Animalia kingdom. Animalia means we are the multicellular. Level of organization of animal on the basis of their organization. Cellular level. Second one is the tissue organ or organ system level. On the basis of cellular level, this animal is divided into, without their symmetry and body cavity, into porifera. First phylum of the animal is the porifera. In which, on the basis of their cellular level organization, this animal is divided into first phylum, porifera. Next, tissue, organ and organ system level. This tissue, organ and organ system are further they have symmetry, vertical symmetry, this is radial and bilateral, radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. In the radial symmetry, on the basis of radial symmetry, this animalia is divided into, without their body cavity, cylindrata, that is cnidaria and ctenophora. So we can consider first animal phylum in porifera in this chapter, then cylindrata, then ctenophora. After that, on the basis of their radial symmetry, on the basis of their bilateral symmetry, they are three. Without body cavity, they are called acoelomates, absent of coelom, body segmentation, and second one is the with false coelom, that called pseudocoelomate, and third one is the with the true coelom, that is called coelomates. Already I told about yesterday about this symmetry, basic symmetry, radial and bilateral in detail. Today I am going to only introduce about the bilateral and radial. So without body cavity, acoelomate, absent of coelomate. The next phylum is the Plati, Helminthes, and with false coelom or pseudocoelomate. Next animal phylum is Schelminthes. Schelminthes, and next with true coelom or coelomate. Next phylum of this animalia is Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata, and last Chordata. These are the phylum we will learn in this chapter detail about that. So by that, we conclude the general classification of animal in the short view. When exam agar pucha jayega ki short answer question mein only write about the general introduction of all phylum of the animalia. So you can write by this way: kingdom, level of organization, making a heading, kingdom, level of organization, symmetry, body cavity, in the bracket coelom, and last one is the phylum. You can write kingdom Animalia, multicellular. Say level of organization of Animalia is cellular level and tissue, organ and organ system level. On the basis of cellular level, no symmetry, no body cavity found in the porifera, first phylum of Animalia. On the tissue, organ, organ system level, they are divided into radial. They have symmetry, radial and bilateral. In the radial, they have no body, they will be divided into cylindrata and tenophora. And on the basis of their bilateral symmetry, they are without body cavity. They have also body cavity. Without body cavity, acoelomate divided into phylum Platyhelminthes with false synonym pseudo called pseudocoelomate divided into the Escahelminthes phylum and last with the true synonym coelomates from Annelida to the Chordata, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata and Chordata. These are the phylum we will learn in this chapter in detail. इनके बारे में हम लोग इसमें वन बाय वन डिटेल में पढ़ेंगे. उनका कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर, बॉडी सिमेट्री, सब कुछ वन बाय वन. बट दिस इज द टेबल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ एनिमल क्लासिफिकेशन. सो कंक्लूड दैट वी विल लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर अबाउट पोरीफेरा, सिलेंट्रेटा, टीनोफोरा, प्लेटीहेलमिंथीज, एस्केहेलमिंथीज, एनिलिडा, आर्थ्रोपोडा, मोलस्का, इकाइनोडर्मेटा, हेमीकॉर्डेटा एंड कॉर्डेटा. दीज आर द फाइलम 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. अबाउट 11 फाइलम्स ऑफ एनिमेलिया और एनिमल वी विल लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 4, एनिमल किंगडम. Yes, my dear student, focus on first phylum of animal is Porifera. Let us study about detail about Porifera. Porifera and also called as the commonly they are sponge. Sponge. One by one, their characteristic feature is written here. Porifera mostly found in marine. They are asymmetrical and cellular level of organization. This phylum Porifera found in habitat is in marine system, asymmetrical and cellular level organization, and they are also multicellular organism. They are multicellular organism. Next, they have water canal system. Water canal system means they have a small pores which fill the water from the surrounding mediums. Water canal system. Ostia is present on the body surface of this Porifera organism in the form of spongocoel, that is osculum. This is a small pores. Small pores present on body surface of Porifera organism. Ostia is a spongocoel or osculum present on the body surface, that is a small pore like structure which absorb the water from the surrounding medium. Next, the quinocytes. Quinocytes are cells, collar cells lying on the spongocoel. These are the collar cell lying on spongocoel, means on ostia. Also help in the water absorbing in the Porifera. Next, digestion is intracellular. Digestion is intracellular means within the body digestion takes place in the Porifera. And skeleton is made up of the spiculum, spicules and sponging fibers. Their body structure is made up from or skeleton made up of spicules and spongo fiber that help to support the medium and give the internal and structures external support to the body of Porifera. Next, they are hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means their sex sex organ are not separated. So male and female organs present on the same body of the Porifera. They are hermaphrodite means their sex organs are not separated. So we can say male and female organ present on the same body system in the Porifera. They reproduce asexually by process of fragmentation and sexually by formation of gametes. They are reproduced asexually by the process of fragmentation and sexually by the formation of gametes. And fragmentation is internal and development is indirect. This fragmentation is internal types and fragmentation and development of body is indirect. These are the basic characteristic feature of the porifera. Once again, this is a classification of animal in which first is phylum porifera. Porifera is commonly known as spawn. They are mostly found in this porifera found in habitat marine water. They are asymmetrical cellular level of organization and also they are multicellular organism. They have water canal system which help in the absorb the water from the surrounding medium. Next, ostia eye sponges seal or osculum present on the body surface of porifera which absorb the water from the surrounding medium and help the transportation of minerals and water in the whole body of porifera. Next, they have coenocytes or collar cell line in the sponge cell. They have the collar cell lines that help in the cellular level of cellular organization. Next, digestion is intracellular, means their digestion process takes place within the body, and also their skeleton is made up of spicules and spicule or esponjian fiber which help mechanical support and physical support to the body of porifera. Next, they are hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means their sex organ are not separated. So we can say their male and female organ system is present on the same body surface. Next, they reproduce asexually by the process of fragmentation and sexually by the process of making gametes. And fragmentation is internal, takes place in the body of porifera, and development is indirect development. An example of this porifera is cycam, eusporia and spongilla. Here in figure you can see cycam, eusporia and spongilla. They are sponge-like structure. Their body has the canal system and osculum is present, and that help in the transportation of water along that minerals present in the surrounding medium, also in the spongia and sponges. Spongiola is called both sponge. Eusporia found in the freshwater system and cycam is numbering. So these are the all about porifera, their characteristic feature which is important for your examination. Last 2 years question came from this first of porifera, that helpful for you, and you can write about question may be arising from the right general characteristic feature of phylum porifera along that example question. This one as you can write by in your language using these terms that I written on blackboard, and you will give good mark in your exam. Thanks. My dear student, next phylum is Coelenterata. Coelenterata also known as Cnidaria. Their nickname is Cnidaria. So this is the next phylum of Animalia. Let us consider their general characteristic feature of phylum Coelenterata. One by one. They are mostly found in aquatic medium and marine medium. Found in aquatic and marine. They are sessile. Sessile means fixed anthroposition, and sometimes they are free swimming. Coelenterates इनका पहला करैक्टरिस्टिक फीचर क्या होता है, एक्वेटिक जल में पाए जाते हैं और किसमें मरीन में, सेसाइल होते हैं, फिक्स्ड पोजीशन पे भी होते हैं और क्या हो सकते हैं फ्री स्विमिंग, इधर से उधर कहीं पर भी जा सकते हैं। ने देयर बॉडी रेडियली सिमेट्रिकल, इनका जो होता है ये रेडियली सिमेट्रिकल बॉडी पाई जाती है इनकी। दे हैव नीडोब्लास्ट, नीडोसाइट्स एंड स्टिकिंग कैप्सूल ऑन देयर टेंटकल्स दैट यूजफुल फॉर डिफेंस, एंकरेज एंड टू कैप्चर द प्रे। इनकी बॉडी में पाए जाते हैं भैया टीनोब्लास्ट, नीडोसाइट, सॉरी नीडोब्लास्ट एंड नीडोसाइट, और जो क्या होते हैं स्टिंगिंग कैप्सूल के रूप में होते हैं ऐसे कांटेदार टेंटिकल की तरह, और वे यूज होते हैं किसके लिए, डिफेंस के लिए, सुरक्षा के लिए उसके, एंकरेज के लिए मीन्स बॉडी डेवलपमेंट के लिए, एंड टू कैप्चर द प्रे शिकार को पकड़ने के लिए। नेरेलिया में भी कॉमनली कम फ्रॉम द प्रेजेंस ऑफ टीनोब्लास्ट, नीडोब्लास्ट एंड नीडोसाइट्स। नेक्स्ट, टिश्यू लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन दिस सिलेंट्रेटा इज डिप्लोब्लास्टिक, इन दिस टिश्यू लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आर डिप्लोब्लास्टिक। डाइजेशन इज एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर एंड इंट्रा सेलुलर, डाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस इन द सिलेंट्रेट बाय द एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर एंड इंट्रा सेलुलर। दे हैव कोरल स्केलेटन मेड ऑफ कैल्शियम एंड कार्बोनेट, देयर स्केलेटन इज मेड अप ऑफ कैल्शियम एंड कार्बोनेट, कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट। दे एग्जिबिट टू बेसिक फॉर्म ऑफ कॉल्ड पॉलिप्स एंड मेड्यूसा, दे एग्जिबिट टू बेसिक फॉर्म्स कॉल्ड पॉलिप्स एंड मेड्यूसा। पॉलिप इज सेसाइल मींस दे आर फिक्स्ड एंड सिलेंड्रिकल, मोस्टली फाउंड इन हाइड्रा, and medusa are free living, they are free living, they are umbrella like structure mostly found in jellyfish, and they the cylindrata shows the alternation of generation means metagenesis, they show the alternation of generation in the sexually metagenesis, polyp form medusa by asexual method and medusa form polyp by sexually. These are the basic structure characteristic feature of cylindrata. Once again, phylum cylindrate, they are called also cnidaria, mostly found in aquatic medium that is marine, they are sessile or free swimming, and their body is radically symmetrical. They have nidoblast, nidocyte, stinging capsule on the form, in the form of tentacles which help in the defense, encourage and to capture the prey. They have tissue level of organization are diploblastic. Digestion extracellular or intracellular takes place in the cylindrate. They have coral skeleton is made up of calcium carbonate. And they exhibit two basic forms called polyp and medusa. And polyp is sessile. Sessile means fixed. Means they are cylindrical. Generally found in hydra. And medusa is free swimming. And they are umbrella like. They can move in the aquatic medium from one place to one place. They are free swimming animals. And they this cylindrate show the alternation of generation means metagenesis, in which polyp form medusa by asexual method and medusa form polyp by sexual method. Example of this hydra, physalia, sea anemone, sea pen, etc. Different example in which aurelia, medusa, you can see this is the umbrella like, they are free swimming, and this Advasia is a polyp, they are sessile, fixed on the in the aquatic medium. These are the characteristic features of phylum Cylindrata and their example.